get to like answer the questions in your head. Alrighty? Okay, so if you guys wanna like remember anything, we'll do that at the end of the this portion. So again, I am Lisa Pressman and I am with Fujifilm. I'm a Fujifilm user for like 5 years, 6, maybe 7 years already. I am also a social media content curator if you guys follow me on Instagram, and also a business owner of Miss G, a restaurant and a bar in Poblacion. And I also handle the social media marketing of that, and also a new company that's gonna come at the end of this year. So basically, all of my work involves social media, pictures, videos, and stuff like that, all for content creation. All right, so I'm gonna be talking about, next. So I'm gonna be talking about an artist's perspective on one's creative process. Also guys, what I do for a hobby is painting. For me, it's like my stress reliever. It's where I like express myself. Although I have stopped for quite a long time and I'm getting back to it. And I have built my creative process, or a process of like, how do I get back to being creative again? All right, so I'll be talking about the creative process. So what is a creative process? Honestly, no one man or person could actually describe what a creative process is. Or yeah, you could say the meaning, but then naturally it's a map that builds up your creativity so that you come out with something creative or push yourself to create something. But honestly, there's no one way, there's no one map. I could only share with you guys the guide that I have searched on, like on the internet by different researchers, different talks and stuff like that. But then honestly, the actual maps and the actual steps and stages will all come from you, because everything being creative all comes from within and in your mind, heart, soul, whatever. Okay, so these are like the top 5 steps that I have seen. So this one first is the preparation stage. So naturally, you prepare yourself. Before you dive into something, you gotta know what you wanna get into. You gotta like have an idea of where you would wanna go, what you would wanna do, where you would wanna end up. So first of all, this is the preparation. So you prepare yourself, it's like you indulge yourself, or you put yourself in a certain environment where you get more information about the thing that you wanna do. So for example, if you are an artist, you go to different galleries. You look at different painters. Like maybe there's a specific style that you wanna go for, you can search for this artist and then search for that style. And then the more you look at it, the more you absorb that, the more you're gonna learn. And for example, if you're a doctor, then you could go to different talks, or different, you could read different books, talk to different doctors, so that you get to gain more information, just so that you're very familiar with what you wanna do. Next, we've got the incubation stage. So this one's the second one. The incubation is when you try to explore and experiment on everything. Actually, this is also the place where you just like out of the blue, like not out of the blue, it's more like when you have an idea and you think about it, you really, really think about it, but before you act up on it, this is when you like sleep on it. So you sleep on it. You know, like there are times when I create a poster, for example, that we would have to post for an event. I think it's nice because I worked on it the whole day. So dahil buong araw ko siya pinaghirapan, ito na yung parang for me, ito na yung end ko. Okay na ako dito. And then when I sleep, and then I wake up again, the next day, parang, it's not really the best thing to do. So again, a process takes time, being creative takes time. So take that time to like really, like refresh your mind every now and then. That's why it's also important to just like sleep on it. And don't pressure yourself. And then next is the illumination stage. So the illumination stage is the eureka stage, or like the aha stage, you know? Like when you suddenly think of an idea. Usually this happens, for some people it happens when you're in the shower. You know, when you're just like taking a bath, or like you're chilling or whatever, and then an idea comes up in your head. And then that's why it's very important to either have a pen and notebook with you all the time, but then that's kind of hard to do. Or at least like, sa notes mo on your phone, just keep writing down those ideas. Because honestly, so many times, there are like ideas that come up in my head, and then I'm like, oh my God, this is gonna sell so well, I love this idea. And then after a couple of hours, I can't remember it. It really happens, it really does. So every time that you get that like, idea in your head, just like write it down and then keep it. That's gonna be really useful. And the next 4th is the evaluation stage. So this is when you actually evaluate your idea. So it's, you could ask your friends or you could ask other people about this idea, if it's good, if it's gonna work or whatever. But then I'm telling you guys, be ready for criticism. It's really gonna come, it's gonna happen, but then don't let that like pull your idea down. You know, just like make it useful. Honestly, when I post something or if I paint something or draw something, I ask a bunch of people, I'm like, what do you guys think of this? Not because I'm not sure or not confident of what I want or what I want to do, but because I just want an opinion from someone else. And then I could take that, I could either change my idea or my art or my work and adjust to them if I think that that would be the best for me too. But then if I just want to take that as a comment and then slightly change it to improve, then that's the best thing to do. Because honestly, we all just want to improve our work anyway. Okay, and then next is the implementation stage. So this is when we actually work on it. So this is when we actually make a move on whatever you want to do. So for example, if it's photography, this is when we actually shoot already. And because you went through all of the stages already, you're ready to go to your set, you're ready to shoot your artist, your subject, or whatever, and you're prepared for everything. And then, so my perspective as an artist, as I said a while ago, my hobby is also painting, but then I have stopped for probably a year, and I'm getting back to it this month because I'm working on a project for the Amazon, if you guys heard of what's going on in the Amazon. So basically, what I want to do is I'm going to make a painting, have it bid, put it up for bidding, and then whatever money I make out of that, I'll be donating to the Amazon. So I am really pushing myself to get back to art. And I'll just show you guys my creative process in doing that next, please. So what is the preparation stage? So it was knowing my purpose. What, like I had to think like, okay, I needed to have a purpose to get back into it again because I've stopped for so long. And then my incubation, illumination, evaluation stage, I went through all that also, like, I went through like researching, knowing what to do, and then for my case, it was for the Amazon, I had to research what was the best thing to do. You know, there's a lot of things about like, you could plant trees, or you could eat less meat, and stuff like that. But then I wanted something more useful. What could I do to help them right now? And that would be donating, donating money or whatever I make out of that painting. And then the implementation stage is what I'm going to be doing tomorrow or the next day, which is actually creating the piece that I want to do. But then again, next, sometimes it's not so easy to keep following a path. Sometimes you just want to jump into it, which is okay because other people are more creative than others. Sometimes you could be creative every day and you could think of something to draw or paint or shoot every single day, but then on that actual day, you feel blank. You feel like, oh, I don't know what to do, I don't know what to draw, I don't know what to create. So yeah, as long as you guys have the right balance and the right mixture of knowing like how you would naturally want to do it yourself, then of course, that is also up to you. And again, this process, this is not like a must. You could have this as a guide, the process that I just mentioned, but then of course, your creative process is still gonna be your own personal creative process. And then that is where my short talk is gonna end because we are gonna start with the interview with Henry.